Willkommen in Erdorbe Detlef's Elfen Dungeon. We have no elves, and not the dungeon, but whatever. Sponsored by Trial. So, do you have to go somewhere, in person, instead of just using the internet like a normal person? Well, would you like to take an aeroplane? Maybe, but it's very expensive and emits lots of gases and people are very upset about that these days, so maybe we want something more efficient. Maybe you could ride a bicycle, because it is better than a car, much more narrower and more efficient, and it's cheaper. But problem is, maybe you get tired. So we will add a motor. Now we have a motorcycle, but you still have to balance it and pay very close attention. Much better if you could have it drive itself, and then also if it was much bigger, so you could sit in it and instead of being out on the weather and stuff. Maybe you could take your baggage with you, like your violin, or whatever you want to take with you. So a problem with this is it needs to be able to drive itself, and two wheels, very hard to balance. It can be done, less efficient of course, and maybe if there's wind or something, or it falls over and wants to get back up, well, we want it to be able to do that. So we have something like this, where we have a cab section with the engine and stuff, and then it can move using four-bar mechanism, and now it can balance itself and park and all kinds of wonderful things like that. So, what is good about this design? Well, it's very large wheels, so if you go off-road, there's no problem. You can go over rocks and big logs and whatever you're running over, I don't know, up and down hills and in mud and things, and the big tires will make it much more smoother than the small tiny tires. So you don't need a road, but if you have a road, like most people have roads these days, then you can use it two to a lane instead of one, and then you've doubled the capacity of your road. So that seems good, not stuck in traffic again. And we can make it even better. If our tires are conformal, which is they can inflate and deflate, then we can go on railroads, because you can just ride the rim directly on the rails, and that is great, because now your gauge does not matter, and you can double the capacity of your railroads. So that's wonderful. And also, you can have fast response little tiny tires, like maybe like toes or something, and they can be reactive, so if there's a rock in the road, and then you deflate just one, as the computer does it for you, of course. You're not going to be hitting switches and stuff inside. That would be ridiculous. Anyway, you've got the clogs, and you can get them out, and you can get, you know, like wiggling your toes if you go through mud or something. And then, even if you've got some sort of giant chasm or city or something, because people hate getting run over there in cities, then you can have a cable car, where you just string a big rope up, or maybe a steel cable or something. You only need to build a few towers, and presto, you have bridge over impassable thing like volcano fortress or whatever. So there you have it, the Triap Omnibike. It's for when you just can't phone it in, because, you know, you have to be there in person, instead of using the internet to phone it, like I am doing, because here I am on the internet, and I didn't come to you in an omnibike. Why would I do that? That's ridiculous. But anyway, if you need to be someplace, like, I don't know, you have a baby child going to be born, or you need to go to an important meeting, something, well, you need to be somewhere, just as long as it's not a military invasion or something like that, because then you just use aeroplane like everybody else. I mean, that's what aeroplanes are great for, rockets and missiles and things flying through the air very fast. It's hard to stop. Omnibike, you could stop it, but you wouldn't want to, because you're just doing something entirely benign. Yeah. Well, that was it for Colonel Detlef's Invention House. Our feet are sane.